Many have wondered about the effectiveness of the air defense system protecting the airspace around Washington, D.C. It turns out to be extremely good. The U.S. military has successfully carried out the lowest ever intercept of a Mach cruise missile using the National Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile System, or NASAMS, during a test earlier this month. Probably unknown to most Americans, NASAMS is the main surface-to-air missile system in the National Capital Region. It's part of a layer setup and is augmented by AN-TWQ-1 Avenger short-range air defense systems, which are deployed at important locations. Viewers may note that U.S. Air Force F-16 C and D Viper jets and Coast Guard MH-65 Dolphin helicopters are also available for a quick response. The test took place on September 3, 2020, and involved a NASAMS situated on Santa Rosa Island, located off the coast of Florida in the Gulf of Mexico. As part of this test, a very low-flying, unmanned BQM-167 Skeeter target drone was intercepted. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the presence of the National Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile System makes Washington, D.C. one of the most well-protected capitals in the world. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. NASAMS is built by Raytheon Corporation and Kongsberg Defense & Aerospace. The Norwegian company Kongsberg Defense & Aerospace teamed up with Raytheon and initiated the NASAMS program as a cooperative effort for the Royal Norwegian Air Force. The network-centric air defense system, NASAMS, was declared fully operational capable in 1998, but had an initial operational capability as early as 1994 or 1995. The Royal Norwegian Air Force, together with Kongsberg Defense & Aerospace, conducted a midlife update of NASAMS called NASAMS 2, and the upgraded version was first handed over to Royal Norwegian Air Force in mid-2006. The major difference between the two versions is the use of Link 16 on NASAMS 2, as well as a better ground radar. Full operational capability, FOC, was reached in 2007. A complete NASAMS 2 battery consists of 12 missile launchers, LCHR, each one carrying 6 AIM-120 AMRAAM missiles, 8 radars, AN-MPQ-64 Sentinel F-1 improved Sentinel X-band 3D radar, 1 fire control center, CTOC, 1 electro-optical camera vehicle, MSP-500, and 1 tactical control cell, TCC, vehicle. The mobile launcher can be deployed and remotely controlled up to 25 kilometers or around 15.5 miles away from the fire control center. Each launcher can fire the 6 AMRAAMs in seconds against 6 different targets, enabling multiple simultaneous engagements. Since 12 launchers are present with 6 missiles each, the system can target up to 72 targets simultaneously. The AN-MPQ-64 Sentinel is a 3D radar used to alert and cue short-range air defense, SHORAD, weapons to the locations of hostile targets approaching their frontline forces. It's an X-band range-gated pulse Doppler radar system. The antenna uses phase frequency electronic scanning technologies, forming sharp 3D pencil beams covering large surveillance and track volume. The radar automatically acquires, tracks, classifies, identifies and reports targets, including cruise missiles, unmanned aerial vehicles, and both rotary and fixed-wing aircraft. It uses a high scan rate, 30 RPM, and operates at a range of 40 kilometers, or 25 miles. The radar is designed with high resistance to electronic countermeasures, ECM, mounted on a towed platform. It can be positioned remotely from the rest of the unit, operated autonomously, and communicate with the Fire Direction Center, FDC, via a wideband fiber optic link. It can also distribute its data over SyncGAR's radio network. The AMRAAM AIM 120 was developed and is best known as an air-launched fire and forget missile deployed on the F-16, F/A-18, F-22, Eurofighter, JAS-39, Gripen, to name a few. NASAMS uses the AIM 120C7. The AIM 120C7 development began in 1998 and included improvements in homing and greater range. AIM 120C7 incorporates an upgraded antenna, receiver, signal processor, and new software algorithms to counter new threats. The use of smaller system components created room for future growth. This test is the latest in a series of validations being carried out. It's actually been delayed due to Tropical Storm Marco and Hurricane Laura, which bashed the region in August. The U.S. Air Force's 780th Test Squadron, based at Eglin Air Force Base in Florida, led the test as a part of a program called Vermilion Stallion. BQM-167 Skeeter used for this test is a proven system. The Composite Engineering BQM-167 Skeeter is a subscale aerial target drone developed and manufactured by Composite Engineering Inc., which had been acquired by Kratos Defense and Security Solutions. It's developed from the ground up to provide a realistic target for weapons testing. BQM-167 Skeeter has a length of 20 feet and can fly at a maximum speed of 0.91 Mach. U.S. Air Force press release stated, "This live fire made history as the lowest altitude surrogate cruise missile ever impacted with the system. The successful execution enabled the verification, validation, and recharacterization of the nation's air defense system's many upgrades." The airspace around Washington, D.C. is among the most heavily restricted and monitored in the world, and its protection is taken very seriously. This test assumes special significance when we take into consideration some recent events. In January 2018, Russian forces faced a drone swarm launched against Khmeimim Air Base in Syria. The Russians were able to neutralize most of these. Though the attack was not able to inflict major damage, it indicated that the threat of the low-flying weapon is real. A relatively recent example is the attack on Saudi Arabia. On September 14, 2019, facilities of Saudi Arabia's oil company, Aramco, located in the east of the country, came under attack. As per reports, 18 drones and 7 missiles were used for the coordinated attack. The damage was significant, and this caused a spike in global oil prices. Unlike earlier times when ballistic missiles were the only concern, now with the proliferation of low-flying drones as well as cruise missiles, things have become more complex. Hence, the successful interception of the Mach cruise missile flying at very low altitude by NASAMS is an important step, as it will add a lot of confidence.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.